Hello everyone, my name is Drew and today I will be walking you through a bit of Stronghold Kingdoms. Now last time we talked about attacking, this time we're going to be talking about defending and building, particularly your castle and how to place troops and how to build a castle from scratch. Now I'm not going to do a traditional design which I'll show you as or a moat design. I'm going to do kind of a hybrid of the two. I'm going to show you examples and I'm going to show you the end result of the castle. Now I'm going to start out by saying, if you notice in the top left, I have full stockpile of every single good. What this allows me to do is build a castle fast. And I spent a good half hour deleting all the tiles in my castle so I can show this to you. Now I have the infrastructure saved so I can show you real quick. And there it is. That's the end result. I'll be playing through and showing you exactly how I built this and why I built it the way I did. Alright, so let's start off with a couple castle designs. Alright, here we have a traditional design done by a player who uses the strength of towers to really defend against catapult attacks. Now, the only thing wrong with this castle, I would say, is that the turrets are too far away from the keep, and I don't know what this mess is over here. But other than that, it's a pretty good design. You have the ballistas out towards the outer rim of the castle, and the ballistas range is roughly about 42 squares. And by square, I mean one of those little, you know, like a wall structure or something. And from there, I wouldn't put my gatehouse right there either. And the way to really defend an attack when you don't know which side they're attacking is exactly like this. Put 9 archers on each tower, and the range of an archer on the side of a tower is about 27 tiles, which again we're talking about these little things here. And going from that, we go to a player named Debo, he's probably one of the best defenders in the game. This is his design on a particular attack that was done to him. And they had 7 timed attacks and a captain on this attack. They went front door, which I don't have the reports because it was over 30 days ago, which if you didn't know, after 30 days the report gets deleted. So here you don't see him doing this design where he has more out towards the outside. He worries about the inside, and he's defending the middle attacks with moat and pitch. This is done because catapults cannot dig up moat. And you may be thinking to yourself, well, that doesn't matter if there's no archers. It really does matter. With 5 captains in the keep and all these archers around the keep, on top of towers like that, it will take a lot to raise this castle. And because he's done this, he survived the 7 attacks on the captain. So, in saying that, let's go ahead and get started on actually building the castle. We're gonna do a mix between the massive moat and of course the traditional design, which is all towers. So first what you want to do is since the actual square of the castle is not full, what you want to do is I always start with the middle. So you want a strong inside of by your keep. So what you do is get it all the way over here, and that way it can go in front and on the sides, the great towers. Now, this right here that I'm about to do is what I do. Some players do something different, but it's pretty much a variation of the two. Now you have the gatehouse in the back, which you don't have to worry about them attacking from the back, because if you get attacked from the back, they have to destroy all these towers on the sides and in the front, because when the melee troops walk through the back, they get funneled into these little single file, which you don't want, because they'll die a lot quicker, especially if there's archers still on these walls. So unless you're sending about 30 attacks timed, or even 10-20 of big catapult armies like province or county armies, then there's really no reason to put that tower back there. These turrets will do a lot of damage on their own. And then from there, I then do the corners. Now the corners are important because you can fit 8 great towers and 1 of the medium tower here, or the large tower. And from there, I then do the one large tower, and remember it's one large tower per row. So I'm going to go back here also, and I'm going to do it like that. Now, in doing that, as soon as I have that set, it's really, you want to keep your guardhouses, your smelters, and your ballistas in the corners. The reason you do this is because if you look at this castle, for instance, most of them are in the corners, and what happens is they'll send attacks, and the catapults are always aimed towards the middle. They're always aimed at this little bit here. They'll go forward like that or through the side. If you do get attacked in the corners, it's usually in the back. That's when they're attacking early to make you card up the castle, be able to put this many troops in. And when they do that, you can all you have to do is place the barracks down. Who cares about the rest of your towers here? The barracks take about an hour to build, which on a card, I'll show you that later, it's not that much once you card it. Okay, now we're going to start building the barracks, and I'm going to start with the back here. Now, like I said, everyone has their own variation on how they place these things. It's really a matter of your different playing style and how you actually defend. A lot of players have many different tactics. This is just my own. I don't swear by it, but I do recommend it for anyone who wants to get a knack of how it is defending. Now, if you notice, a player by the name of Unarmed Bandit taught me this, that when you have the towers, the large towers next to the great tower like that in the corner, you can place smelters in there. And the smelters, actually, because they're an extra length from the actual guardhouses, they fit in there a lot better. All right, so I'm just doing this one extra because I don't want to get too far indented in, and then I won't be able to put another large tower there. And just give me a second, I'm just going to do a time lapse of me placing all these barracks and things like that, alright? Alright, and now we get to the point to where I know the guardhouse placement is a little bit messy. Like I said, it varies from castle to castle. You can see the different actual designs here that people did, and there's not really a set way to do it. Everyone does something different at any point in time. Now, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to mix it up and I'm going to put moat. Now, normally, when you have three rows of great towers like this, you can't fit another one, so you put a row of large towers. Now I'm going to replace that row of large towers, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a row of moat here. Okay. Now a few months back they did an update to where the moat is a lot stronger now than what it used to be, and because it's a lot stronger, a lot of players have been implementing it into the actual design of their castle. Now, I usually try to mix it up. I have, on many occasions, put moats, like right here, what I'm doing is I'm putting moats in between where I would normally put stone. And players do this, and like I said, a lot of them swear by it, a lot of them don't. So, give me a second. Alright, so now we click confirm. Now, as you can see here, we're already up to 24 days in completion. Now, we can get down to carding a castle once we're done building it. But right here, if you look at what we have so far, we have enough to really defend a raise attack if your castle's already blown wide open. I wouldn't say that it would defend It wouldn't defend a full 6 or 7 right now because there's no walls in between and it's not guarded, of course. Then there's no troops on the walls. But let's go ahead and we'll close it off so we don't have that little multiplier for the popularity. And then what you want to do when you set your exit is you want to have it on the top left and the back side. What this does is you never want your exits to go out the front. You can have it go out the bottom right, but really the front door is the worst place to have an exit. Because when these Sally Forth come out, and they will, when they come out, you want them to go out the back or the top left, because these are the least attacked sides. And what happens is when they come out, they go around the outside. And a lot of times by the time they're right here, or say for instance right here, the troops are already somewhat inside of your castle, and you go straight for the catapults. And it makes them do a lot less damage than they normally would. And if you're Sally Forth, if the way out is in the front, what happens is they run straight into the troops and they don't go after the catapults at all. Okay? So, with that being said, the actual tunneler's hole, which is right here, it takes 3 hours to build, but you can instantly move it just by placing it again and click confirm. You can see that it was instantly moved. Alright? So, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to start filling in all this. I'm just going to do it a bit fast and I'll see you when I'm done. Alright, so now that that's done, like I said, a lot of the placement kind of screwed with the way my smelters that were actually placed, but I have moat on 3 sides, and what you can do with the moat is you can put, when the oil pots drop, which are these things here, it's 5 oil pots per smelter placed. So right now I'd be able to place about 25 oil pots, which should be sufficient enough. And then again, if I start getting attacked, I can always delete a tower and place some more smelters. But what I was getting at was they drop fire for 2 tiles. And so I have about 5 tiles of moat here. So what I'm going to do is in the middle here, I'm going to delete one every other. Now you've kind of seen this in the example I showed you earlier. And what this does is, while they're digging the moat, they'll get burned. And when they get burned, they die a lot quicker from my archer shooting them. I kind of just messed up there. But when they're burning, their health goes down a lot quicker, and they can't really dig when they die. So then what I'll do is I'll place a wall here, because you have to place the oil pots on top of the wall, which could be a bit out of your way, considering catapults can break down walls. But the thing about oil pots is, say for instance, the catapults destroy these little single walls that I have in the middle of the moat before the troops get there and allow them to tip over. On the next attack, they'll spawn on the ground and tip over when a troop gets near it. So, this would be your basic design. Of course, you finish filling it in. But yeah, as you can see, we're at roughly 26 days of building. As you can see, I started with a full stockpile of both stone and wood. Now, I could go through another 10,000 stone, give or take, of just filling in the gaps and making sure, you know, there's no more empty spaces like you see in the back here. But now what I'm going to show you is the actual offense cards that you play when you're getting attacked. And again, it varies by what you have. Now, they made a nice little filter button. So now what you do is you just click castle cards. And what you want to play is a advanced stone walls card. This makes your walls 2 times stronger. You click that and it gets played. Now you can either play the advanced color arms or the regular color arms depending on how far away the attacks are. And then the improved stone structures. There is an advanced stone structures card, which is a times 2. but it is very, very rare and very hard to get. Now, once you play those three, you can click the army card. What is it? I believe it's under troops, yes. Improve guardhouses. Now, normally with guardhouses, you can place 400 troops. When you play that card, you can place up to 520 troops, which allows you to get results such as this, where you have all those archers on every single tower, as well as like this, where you have and just a plethora of troops on top of the walls. Now, going back, those are the cards that you would have in play. You could also have in play a Vance Pits card, but as you can see, I don't really have that many killing pits. But like I said, you can also play it if you would like to. You don't really need the stronger stone wooden walls, gates, and platforms, because I don't have any of those placed within my castle. Now, they do have a knight card, which what happens is the surprise attack happens at the start of the siege, which means if I would play this, as soon as the person starts attacking me, 12 knights would come out. This is only on one attack. So on the next attack, 12 more knights would not come out. And then I have this one here called Last Stand. Last Stand happens when the troops are within a certain, I believe it's 5 tiles of the keep. And what happens is the knights charge out, because if you didn't notice, when you're getting attacked, the sally forth only comes out 3 times. So if they get to your keep and there's no more sally forth, you could be, lack for another word, screwed. Okay? And you don't want to be screwed when they're that close to your keep. So that's why you play the knight cards. Now, if your castle is destroyed, say for instance this is your castle, you're getting attacked with multiple attacks, you would have to play cards. Now, one of the tricks is that you could play an expert mason's card, which you see here. It's 5 times castle build speed. And when I place that, this 26 days turns into 5 days. Okay? So once I've played that, I can play a couple of these Master Designer cards, which turns 6 hours into 30 hours because of the times 5. And then, of course, the 12 hours of Castle Wall Construction, which puts 12 hours into 60 hours. Now, if, say, for instance, you're out of these cards, you could buy them. The Castle Designer card is 90 points, I believe, and then the Wall Construction card is like 50 points. Overall, it would take about 600 points to fully... 695 points, I believe, last time I checked, to rebuild a castle with this much build time onto it. And then once you do that, you would go here, and then you would place 5 captains in the keep right away. Okay? And then with the 5 captains in the keep, it's really hard to exactly tell how much damage they do, but 5 captains in the keep can are sufficient to about 2 swordsmen or 3 swordsmen strength as far as attacking. Now, the thing about captains is you want to send a lot of archers if you are attacking, because archers shoot into the keep and will kill captains a lot more. That's why if you do attack and you're expecting 5 captains in the keep, go bottom right on the person. When you go bottom right, the archers kind of arc a bit more, and they'll attack the they'll kill the captains faster. The only bad thing about going bottom right, or even top left for this matter, you have to get rid of these towers right here, because if not, your people are bottlenecked. And again, we go back to the beginning. When you're bottlenecked, your troops die a lot faster because it's just one at a time. Alright, so that has been how to build a castle, or how to defend a castle. If you have any questions, make sure to just message me in-game, and I'll be more than happy to help. Alright, have a great day.